This game is a joke. CD Projekt Red went way in over their heads, and for the multiple reasons I'm going to state, I believe that there is no possibility of fixing this awful game. The biggest criticism I see of the game is that it is completely broken, unstable, and unplayable. I 100% agree with this. This was a huge failure on CD's part, especially since the delays were literally because they wanted to polish it more, and yet they ended up releasing a shit show anyways. The fact that they genuinely thought they could get away with releasing a product that has this much booty cheese is unacceptable and beyond me. That isn't what I think is the biggest problem with Cyberpunk, though. I believe that Cyberpunk's actual game design is heavily flawed. So, when people say, at least when it's fixed, we'll have a fantastic game. If anything, I feel that once the game is in an actually playable state for most people, it'll just expose the major flaws it has. So, I believe the story is pretty garbo. Does that mean I'm in with the cool kids? I used epic lingo. Anyways, the story is really nothing special, and I actually believe that it doesn't do the characters justice. There are only two characters that died that I actually cared about, and one of them literally died off-screen in a blur of bullets and explosions and was never mentioned again. I genuinely only realized that guy was actually dead when I hit the credits, because there's no way they would just kill a main character off in an important scene off-screen. They did. Some of the main characters I believe are actually well fleshed out and interesting. I only say some because most of the characters in the main story have their stories locked behind side quests, which, may I say, is actually just a completely brain-dead decision. I mean, whenever I hear someone say, "You gotta do the side quests, otherwise you're playing it wrong," I feel like I lose a brain cell. Let's all just accept the fact that for an RPG, this is a hilariously bad move. RPGs are supposed to be about choice. That's one of the biggest draw factors for people invested in the genre. But apparently this RPG decided you have to play it how it wants, otherwise it will give you a shit story. Thanks, CD. You really took into account every RPG player out there, and definitely did not leave out the ones that prefer to just play the main story. Not to mention that I won't want to play the side quests if I'm not even interested in the main story, because that's where the meat and potatoes of the story should be. If they don't even get the main story right, why the hell would I go out of my way to experience the side quests? Before you ask, no, I didn't do a single side quest. You know why? The main story was a drag. The only point holding my interest were the handful of interesting characters, which that didn't even pan out, seeing as they'll just disrespect a character by killing them off screen in an explosive heist mission and put no focus on it whatsoever. I played The Last of Us Part 2 recently. I gotta say that I'm super glad I finally played it because I loved it through and through, and I didn't have any of the problems with the story or gameplay that others did, for the most part. Anyways, the reason I bring it up is because I believe there is no way that someone could confidently argue that this character's death in Cyberpunk is a better death than Joel's. You may not like how Joel died, but holy shit did it hit every single person that played it hard. Like basically just the worst gut punch you've ever experienced. That scene was supposed to get you riled up, mad, upset, anxious, etc. The character in Cyberpunk dies and is basically immediately forgotten about. Epic! Joel's death then weighs heavily on Ellie and even Tommy for the rest of the entire game, and it is the driving force of the story. Joel's death is weaved expertly into the story, and the player feels that the whole way through. The mission after Vigo's, "Hey yo, who the hell is that cringy little idiot?" I think you get the point, and honestly, it's even more disappointing because they have such an interesting world with intriguing lore and yes, even characters. It's just sad that all this interesting stuff is not part of the main story whatsoever. I swear if someone comments that they are because the side quests you do actually affect the ending, I'm about to ban you from living. So, the story is overall pretty bad. So let's move to how they screwed up the gameplay and RPG mechanics. Right out of the gates, I gotta say, I think this started as a GTA clone in the distant future. Now, this isn't a negative. One of my favorite games of all time is Sleeping Dogs. It's admittedly a GTA clone, but it does so much more with the concept than GTA has ever done that I can't help to absolutely love it. The biggest difference between the two is that GTA is all about that gunplay and running from cover to cover shooting at other gangsters. In Sleeping Dogs, not only is it based in China, but with the new location comes new cultures, and of course they use the martial arts the East is known for to make an awesome and engaging combat system. In Sleeping Dogs, instead of being a cover shooter, it is now a pretty realistic beat-em-up. Not that they won't go wacky though, like with all the really fun, inventive, and brutal environmental finishers you can do on enemies once you've grabbed them. It also separated itself from GTA by actually being a story of an undercover cop as he struggles between becoming too connected to the criminals he is working to take down, committing some pretty big crimes to get closer to the gang, and doing his job. This is why Sleeping Dogs is remembered by many, and I'm sure still will be way down the line, because it distinguished itself from GTA by fleshing out and reinventing that style of gameplay. That's not even mentioning other smaller things that just add to it being a badass action game, like the fact that you can jump from your car onto the back of another car like a true action movie star. Cyberpunk is nothing special, and I'm sure will be forgotten about quicker than Sleeping Dogs, even though it came out after. The reason I think that it was previously a GTA clone is because the RPG mechanics just aren't well fleshed out at all. Literally all of the skills in the skill tree are purely stat boosts, nothing actually fun and interesting. Sure, you can become a katana-wielding god that can just bum-rush all your enemies and cut them to pieces in seconds, but I don't believe for a second that anyone thinks that's more fun than actually unlocking new abilities that can change and give more options on how to approach combat. Yes, I know that abilities are unlocked by the Ripper Docks and other things, but if I want to unlock new abilities, I'd rather do the much easier and accessible thing of just going straight into a menu and getting them. Heck, they could have added a system where you call up a Ripper Dock, but it's not like a real call, because then when you call them, it takes you into a menu where you can purchase an upgrade, and then they could send over an upgrade in a car. Then you just have to walk a few feet to a car and pick it up, rather than going way out of your way just to go and get an upgrade at a Ripper Dock. So, the combat is quite boring, because you'll mostly just be doing the exact same thing in every situation, like running through the room, cutting everybody up with a katana while popping one of your 100 heals. Yeah, the economy is so screwed. Not only can you barely buy anything cool, but if you just loot everything you see like I did, you'll end up with so many heals that you don't even have to try anymore. So, the skill trees are quite boring, and they don't even affect how the story plays out. The only choices that matter is at the very end of the game, basically. That's quite shit for an RPG. None of these choices are based upon what skills you upgraded either, like how in something like Fallout you would actually be able to heavily affect the outcome of a story just by upgrading the right skill. The fact that the only thing that affects the story outcome are the final decisions and whether or not you did side quests is quite pathetic, because it's basic as hell. But it's also almost like they are begging you to play some more of their game. I mean, I get why they are begging people to play. They know their game is actual garbo. That's two times. Can I be a cool kid now, finally? No? Alright, well, my point is that in an RPG, the decisions you choose literally do not matter until the absolute very end. To go back to what I was saying a while ago, this is the reason I believe it started as a GTA clone. I believe that maybe halfway through development or something, they were like, but we gotta do an RPG, we are known as the RPG company, we have to make it an RPG even though it doesn't even work as an RPG because we are known for our RPGs. Jokes on them, they are no longer known for their outstanding RPGs. I've only believed that because all of the RPG mechanics are not fleshed out at all. They are all surface level trash with no depth. It also seems like they went with the quantity over quality method of screwing yourself over. Nobody cares at all about the desert area outside of Night City, and if you say you do, you are lying to yourself. Everyone came to this game for Night City, not a stupid desert with nothing going on, so just cut the desert entirely. Wow, it's almost like I just saved CD a shitload of dev time because I cut out the unnecessary fat. Let's do it again. Brain dances suck booty cheese. Trash them completely. Nobody came to Cyberpunk for BDs. Wow, it's almost like I just saved CD a shitload of dev time because I cut out the unnecessary fat. Picking your own backstory changes jack diddly squat about the story, so just cut that too. Just start as a street kid. Wow, it's almost like I just saved CD a shitload of dev time because I cut out the unnecessary fat. Camera mode is cool, but it's not absolutely necessary, so trash that too. Wow, it's almost like I just saved CD a shitload of dev time because I removed the customization. I don't think I even need to say why. It's just actually something you would only add when your game is basically done and perfected already. Wow, it's almost like I just saved CD a The RPG mechanics aren't very fleshed out or interesting, so just cut that out entirely. Wow, it's almost like— Now use that insane amount of time you just saved to refine the core gameplay and story. This is easily my biggest problem with the game. They went all in on the whole quantity over quality idea. Luckily, it seems to not have worked out very well. I loved my time with AC Valhalla as well, and in fact I already have a script written up for a review for that, but that's not the point. The point that I am gonna make is that Valhalla was able to flush Cyberpunk out of the water with how much better it did everything. That's an absolute yike. when Ubisoft makes a better RPG than you. The comparison I'm specifically targeting, though, is the side quests. In Valhalla, you don't accept or gather side quests. Sure, there are a handful of quests that you don't have to do, so they could be considered side quests, but like the game doesn't even really fully consider them side quests. They are literally bundled into the same tab as the main quests. I think this was actually a really cool idea because then it's like there are no real side quests, but instead there are just quests you do and quests you don't. And in that way, that kind of mirrors real life. In real life, some things you do and some you don't. Whether they are important things or not is not dependent on if you did them. Then there is my absolute favorite new addition, the world events. The world events are so cool because you don't go up to someone and accept their quest, but rather it's framed as you stumbling upon some random event occurring in the world that you can intervene if you want. They aren't added to the quest log either, so it is literally just there and you can decide if you want to interact with it or not. Not to mention just about every single one of them from my experience was memorable and interesting. I can't think of any other way to describe this other than ingenious game design, and something I've honestly never seen before in gaming. Everyone in the entire city in Cyberpunk has your phone number and will call you, and you have to answer. You don't even get the choice to hang up on them. Cyberpunk is leading the pack in innovative side quest design, obviously. Hold up, civilian number 43 is calling on your cell and you just have to hear what he has to say. You don't wanna? you thought you had a chance? You had your choice? You thought you even had a choice? Oh, you're a funny guy.
Your optimism still sounds like a big fat nothing to me.
Dead set symbol bring anything to mind? Anything.
Seriously, in an RPG, you don't even have the choice to hang up on calls. So basically, GTA 5, something that's not an RPG, has more choice than this. What an absolute embarrassment. I also like that the system for getting new quests is actually worse than the ancient system of just going to an exclamation mark on a map. Good job, boys. We lowered the bar so much that the easiest thing to get right in an RPG, we also got wrong. Just to think about that for a second. Let it stir in your brain juices. They got accepting side quests wrong. How brain dead do you have to be for people to notice? If side quests are this hard for CD to get right, then add them to the pile of stuff to trash. Wow, it's now all they have left is the story and gameplay, so they can focus on making a good game and then making good profits. Wow, it's almost like they're a game company or something. Don't even get me started on combat. Sure, the gunplay is fun. There's even stuff they took out that makes me think that maybe it actually was an in-depth RPG at some point, like how the backstory system used to be you picking your childhood hero, key life event, and why you live in Night City. This sounds cool, as it really could make a very unique character each time, but nah. The childhood hero even has one of them as Johnny Silverhand, which makes me wonder if your childhood hero would have been the person fucking with you in your brain. Then, they realized everyone loves Keanu and so changed it so that the whole focus and selling point would be, "We got Keanu, boys!" That would have been so much more interesting for the construct to be based on the personality of the person the chip is in, rather than a basic bitch, "We put his personality in a chip." Bruh moment. I'm taking it back. I don't think that it started as a GTA clone simply by this choice that was in an earlier trailer, but rather I think it was a full-fledged RPG that was then morphed and changed into an unrecognizable and unfocused mess. Probably due to them thinking literally everyone wants Keanu and only Keanu, he is their star power, and they squeezed that star power dry. Nothing against Keanu himself, though. I think he absolutely nailed the performance for what he was given. I say for what he was given because, honestly, even the writing sometimes is trash. They do this weird thing where they act like they are gangsters using bad grammar, which is fine, I get that's what they are, but then about half the time it honestly sounds like I was listening to cave speak. Like two cavemen found themselves in a dystopian future. I mean, even the people you don't that expect that from, like Goro Takamura, a corpo exec dude, for some dumb reason talks like that. It feels like a script I would have written in like 8th grade when I didn't understand how to do gangster slang and how they would speak, so my solution would be to just cut out grammatically correct parts of sentences and think that's how you do it, but they just end up sounding like cavemen. Not to mention, it completely destroys your immersion if you're like me and decide to roleplay as a fancy and well put together corpo hitman samurai, and yet in dialogue he speaks like a caveman. This feels like the Fallout 4 of the Cyberpunk franchise, except Cyberpunk 2077 is the first game in its franchise, and even saying that does a disservice to Fallout 4. When Ubisoft released 3 entire games this year more stable than CD's Cyberpunk 2077, that's a huge yike. I could never get into The Witcher 3, and I keep seeing more and more problems with Cyberpunk that are just unacceptable. They obviously went with quantity over quality, or maybe they cut out many things to make way for Keanu. Either way, they prioritized the wrong things, and it hurt the game badly. There will be no redemption arc for this game. Some recommendations of things you should play instead of this: Sleeping Dogs, GTA 5, AC Valhalla, Fallout New Vegas, Red Dead Redemption 2, Rampage, Total Destruction for the Nintendo GameCube. Don't worry, there's a reason I said that. Even The Last of Us 2 would be more worth your time, because some will come out of that game loving it. So, to CD Projekt Red, Mario has a more believable world.